ومن أحسن قولا ممن دعا إلى الله وعمل صالحا وقال إنني من المسلمين.
السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم، الحمد لله رب العالمين، والصلاة والسلام على رسوله محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين، أما بعد. So today, inshallah, will be our last segment for the series called Kalimullah. Alhamdulillah, we had a great journey talking about Musa alayhi salam and the lessons and reflections from the time and from the story of Musa alayhi salam. And subhanAllah, one thing that we find in all these lectures that I have been conducting, I've conducted over 20 lectures on the story of Musa alayhi salam. And once again, it was not about the story that we were focusing on, it was about the lessons and reflections. From the time that he was a child to the point that he was a teenager, to the point that he had no place to go, he had no idea. He's a young man, but he has no idea what his future holds for him. At that time, how he turned to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And then after that, how he was able to just stay put in one place, you know, establish a family. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala putting this great responsibility on his shoulder, and then going and confronting the tyrant, the greatest tyrant of that time, and not being fearful of him and being fearless. And not only that, but even when he would talk to him, despite the fact that Musa alayhi salam, he had a stuttering problem, he could not speak very fluently and very fluidly. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave him the ability. He prayed to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for that. And how he was able to go and so eloquently talk to Fir'aun without getting emotional, staying logically on the point. And then after that, his story shows us that how much he had to deal with the ignorance of Bani Israel. And the reason why, you know, subhanAllah, the reason why I want to go through all these stories is because there's so much to be learned from the story of Musa alayhi salam. There is a reason why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he mentioned Musa alayhi salam the most out of all the prophets. He mentioned Musa alayhi salam the most in the Quran. There has to be a reason for that. There's also, we find similarities between the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and Musa alayhi salam. They both are ulul azm prophets. They both were shepherds. They both had to deal with the Jewish community. They both had to make hijrah. They both were at a point that they were growing up in other people's homes. The Prophet ﷺ grew up with his uncle. You have Musa ﷺ growing up in the palace of Fir'aun. They're not in their own homes. We find that a similarity between both of them is that we don't find any mention of their fathers. We find that the Prophet ﷺ, when he was born, he had only his mother there. When Musa alayhi salam, when he was being protected from the army of Fir'aun, who was he protected by? He was protected by his mother. His mother was inspired by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He put something in her heart and she did accordingly. So we find that this is also a similarity between the two of them. Also, we find that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, when it comes to the salah that we pray every single day, who actually gave this suggestion to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam that reduced it from 50 to 5. It was Musa alayhi salam. Out of all these seven skies that the Prophet sallam, he went and he visited different anbiya, one of them was Musa alayhi salam. There is just so much that we find between the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and Musa alayhi salam. And the greatest is the fact that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave us the stories of Bani Israel to tell us that, oh, you Muhammad, that you, the nation of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, make sure you do not make those same mistakes as did Bani Israel did. How they treated and how they objected. We find in Surah Al-Baqarah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he says, this is Allah talking about the Sahaba. He's telling the Sahaba that, do you intend to question, or do you want to question the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam the way Bani Israel, they would question Musa alayhi wa sallam? Meaning that just like
Bani Israel, they would object despite the fact that they know that he is the Prophet of Allah. He is alayhi salam. He is Musa alayhi salam. He has a direct connection with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He's a prophet, yet they would question him. And so Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is telling the Sahaba that do not become like the Bani Israel, how they were with Musa, but become different. When the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, when he was approached by his own Sahaba, and they said, Ya Rasulullah, how is it possible that, you know, that anything that comes to our heart, we will be questioned about it? And what did the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam say? Do not become like Bani Israel, that they said, Sami'na wa asayna, but rather say, Sami'na wa ata'na. So, SubhanAllah, there's just so much more that I can mention over here, but I do request all of our viewers that please go back, look at the videos. There is just so much. And SubhanAllah, of course, I'm just one human being. There is, you know, I tried my best to cover all the lessons and reflections or cover the most of them. Of course, there's still so much more that can be learned from the Quran. And this is the beauty of the Quran. The more you study, the more you learn, the more the Quran opens up upon you, the more you just discover gems in the Quran. So inshallah, we'll finish right here. Inshallah, we do. It's not that this is the end of the road. Of course, we have a new series, inshallah, starting soon in this place. It has something to do with the Quran, but what exactly is the topic, inshallah, I will share with you. I'll share that with you, inshallah, in our next segment. I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to give us the ability to understand these stories. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us the ability to take a reflection from these stories, learn from them, and apply these lessons in our life. Ameen Rabbil Alameen. Jazakumullah khair. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
إن المسلمين والمسلمات والمؤمنين والمؤمنات والقانتين والقانتات والصادقين والصادقات والصابرين والصابرات والخاشعين والخاشعات والخاشعين والخاشعات والمتصدقين والمتصدقات والصائمين والصائمات والحافظين فروجهم والحافظات والذاكرين الله كثيرا والذاكرات أعد الله لهم مغفرة وأجرا عظيما.